This book is called Thoughts Along the Kaiso Road.
I remember you saying once in a lecture that even though you are political Calypsonian, the heart of Calypso is smart.
But because in smart, one has to use a lot of metaphors, one has to use a lot of figures of speech, and one has to have a way of saying them. But smart is a very difficult culture to make. Because not only could you sing smart, they have a way of saying this smart. You ever see Blinken say sing smart?
Only on TV.
Did you hear about the thief in pussy? Cut the hole up in Sandy Grandy. You can't cook and leave it at all. That pussy cattle's make your ball. It's one way to get a relief. So they plan one night to capture the thief. As he crawling by my neighbor's son.
You see a kind of aesthetic about the man that you wouldn't see in an ordinary Californian.
No, but you know, Blakey have...
You had a gum.
The laugh.
You had the laughter. You had the gum. You had the eye. You had the way of seeing the thing. And I say, then you enjoy it. Whenever ordinary man come and sing smart, you say, you ain't saying nothing, you know? You ain't moving here.
But why is smart so central to Calypso?
Calypso live by smart, many of them. Live by smart. Smart brought people into the tent, especially during the period of the Americans here.
So how did the American influence affect that?
Well, the Americans didn't understand, the Americans didn't go for commentary. When they start saying commentary, they tell the Americans to go and suck orange. and they're coming back. They stay for the part that they are smart in it. And when they are singing smart, the Americans gone.
Did Chalky ever write a smart?
No. But I have massaged smart for people. Writing smart is very difficult. So that was an important piece in this book. Another important piece in this book is something I want to talk to teachers. I was talking to teachers about the importance of culture. Culture hasn't reached a lot of our children. Teachers don't teach culture. In that classroom, if you don't show the cultural aspect of the nation, it's dead. I gave a speech at Mount St. Benedict in the 60s. I can't remember it, but I remember parts of it. But I gave up the lecture called the Ten Commandments, showing you for every commandment of God, there are five calypso. I can give five calypsos. So when I reached the sixth commandment, that did, thou shalt not commit adultery. He said, Mr. Liverpool, be happy now because calypsoans they sing all kind of things, but they don't sing about thou shalt not commit adultery. I said, that's how you feel. They don't tell you that, but they're singing it. You can't see, they won't say, thou shalt not commit adultery. They don't say that. But they say it in calypso. So he tell me how. I say, I hope I won't disturb all you. He said, no. I said, listen to Rose. Rose have a calypso call. Give me the thing before you get the ring. I used to lecture more outside than Trinidad and Tobago. Trinidad and Tobago sing outside of the lecture. I do all kind of lectures, all about the place. I do all kind of lecture. And I completely forget all them things. I never used to write them down.
Chalky, thank you.
God bless, man. I hope you enjoy the book.